So they both did the same things, and their goal was to basically gather more and more, or the majority of peoples and beliefs and so-called religions and whatever, under the auspice of their respective religious system or theocracy in both cases. Now, one's Rome, one's Mecca, you know, so, and another aspect of the Babylonian mystery religion is the advent of the mother-child worship. And this was also picked up by the Roman Catholics, and you know, it was said that they renamed all the statues and stuff in the, around the Vatican there. And they used to be Jupiter, Saturn, and all that. And now, you know, and the moon goddess and her child is now Mary and the baby Jesus. You know, so they just took things and they renamed it. And different gods and goddesses or statues thereof are all over, and they've just put a different moniker on. And that's what they've basically done. So, I mean, you know. And the mother-child thing was Tammuz and Semiramis from Babylon. Again, you know. And, you know, this part of the Bronze, if you look, there's a lot of things in Islam which, you know, are thought to be supportive of the Roman system, and they're, you know, they don't, they, you know, they think differently about them and all that, but there are parallels and corresponding things which one could say, you know, well, they believe in Mary, and they believe in Mary, and, you know, from a logical or rational point, if you twisted it around and got it out of context and all that, yeah, you can kind of see it. That's where the deception is involved, with the joining of the two, or the joining to be, as I am predicting. Anyway, so they both have a center in a different area of the world, east-west, one might say, corresponding to the two legs of the beast in question, and that is the Roman Catholic and the Islamic. You know, and you know, going back to Rome again, you know, if you look at their cathedral and all that, and the courtyard out in front and all that. I mean, it's a sun wheel, and it has an obelisk from Egypt, which is used as a marker of time on the sun wheel. It's divided up, and you know, the obelisk is basically Nimrod's missing organ, which is worshipped in various and sundry different ways, but I mean, why would you have Nimrod's organ in the middle of your square, you know, in the middle of a sun wheel in front of so-called Christian church? You really have to think about that. I mean, it's out there in plain sight for everybody to see. And it's like, come on, people. And again, going back to the idols, and there was potentially, or at least it was hinted or stated in more than one thing that I read and watched. There's 360 idols that was put inside the Kaaba. One time, and And coincidentally, I think there's like 360 statues that go around that whole center circle, or you know, on the buildings and surrounding the courtyard outside of the Roman Catholic Cathedral there.
You know, it's 1 o'clock.
Maybe not, you know. Just at that time, it was thought there was 360 days in the year. You know, is there an aisle there for every day of the year? Probably. You know? Whether or not they directly worship them or not is regardless. I mean, in God's stated doctrine, you know, thou shalt not have any graven images, you know, associated with the church or the religion. And here we are, you know, they're bowing down to the mother-child statues, and, you know, Mary and all that. Which, incidentally, we can connect the two churches again with the events in Fatima in, I believe it was 1917. Anyway, the image of Mary and the popularization or incorporation of that so-called religious revelation became an avenue for a lot of people in the area to actually come over to the so-called Christian or Roman Catholic church. And so there's kind of a competition even over there as far as the area of the world goes. Anyway, so one place we got the sun wheel and the you know, Nimrod's thing, and the other one we got you know, the Kaaba, which is in itself a you know, well, basically, the black cube is Saturn. At one point in time in history, it was known as the sun, and whatever. But it's the color black itself is associated with the Saturn, which. Anyway, so you got a star, a fallen star there in the corner of the Kaaba. It's a stone, and they worship it, and they kiss it, and all that. And, you know, the Roman Catholics bow to statues, and it's all that. So they're both idolaters in their own way. And they both go back to the origins in Babylon. Okay. So these are all things that are quite the a lot of similarities and perhaps coincidences, but I wouldn't say, you know. Now, like I said, the different names and different versions of the same gods and goddesses pretty much are widely accepted throughout that entire area and the East and the West at the times when these two religions were in the process of being, you know, theocratized or whatever. They're both a means of control, and the theocracy is a power structure. In those countries where the Catholic or Islamic religions are established and maintained, it's virtually impossible for one to go against the culture and the religions and the society and the powers that be in those respective areas to think or act in any way that is contrary. Therefore, you know, your chance of remaining a Christian or becoming a Christian are pretty slim. And in fact, both the Islamic and the Roman Catholic Church have persecuted the same populations historically, the Jews and the Christians. And if you put these two together, they are, as one, they are the most Jew and Christian killing system ever invented. And they're still doing it. You know, I mean, look at the news, look it up. You can see Christians are being persecuted all the time over there. And the Jews don't stand a chance outside of Israel. Okay, so I've gone over the some of the similarities of the in the thought or theme that both legs of the Roman kingdom or empire beast are related or at least very similar in their etiologies and their functions and the manner in which they were able to purvey control and maintain control in their respective areas. And then with regard to the Protestant Reformation, which came out of the Roman branch, you know, that's a whole other system, and indeed is more likely the restoration of the original church and religion as it was meant to be. And, you know, they're on. So, this being a false religion, but with the basis going back to the Christian principles, and then even further back into the Israel and the Jews. But Islam was basically created by Muhammad and his followers and the Hadiths and the Quran and all that, which have changed and evolved over time to a degree. But they were also based on the thoughts and writings and so-called revelations of one man. Likewise, one could attribute the admonitions, the laws, and the control and the power centered in basically one man, the Pope, in the Catholic, Roman Catholic religion, which spread throughout the New World by force and through the way that control, power, and wealth was controlled by the Church. And but anyway, let's examine another religion in the area, which I mentioned, the three major religions. of the Middle East, at least in Jerusalem in particular. Whether one is part of the Roman Catholic system or part of the Islamic system or part of the Jewish system, all three of them basically deny the Christ and have a different view than that of the true Christian church and that which was began in, you know, and explained and historically, you know, goes back to Genesis, to the apocalypse or the revelation through the Bible. So in fact, all of the religions that are based in directly or indirectly in Jerusalem, or that came out of them, with the exception of the Protestant church, are false religions. The Jews, and admittedly, I don't know that much about their system or their beliefs, but I do know that in general they don't believe in Jesus, or they don't believe that he was the Messiah, and that's a denial. Islam, or the Muslim people and their Quran and Hadith, deny Jesus as being the Son of God, as do the Jews. And then the Catholics, who grew indirectly out of the Jewish religion through the Old Testament to the New Testament Christians to the Roman Catholic Church as a usurper and a false modified pagan church as Islam is. In effect, they suggest in their writings and their doctrine and what have you that they are God on earth. I mean, the Pope claims to be the Christ, more or less. And, you know, so these are all false teachings, and they go against the Bible and whatever, so. All three of the major religions that are established or supported or maintained or come out of Jerusalem are false religions, denying the ideals and the Son of God, Yeshua, Jesus Christ, the Messiah. So they are all deceptive, they're all incorrect, and the facets, form, and function of any one of the three are not supported by God in any way, shape, or form. And there, it is mentioned in the Bible itself how the Jewish church was corrupted way back in the day, and there are verses including people in the temple who were, you know, hiding from the view of others and such. They were worshiping the sun god, turning towards the east and worshiping the sun and all that. And I remember the verse about God, I believe he was talking to Ezekiel, sure. Anyway, having to do with Tammuz, weeping for Tammuz. So if you want to look those up and the references to that in particular, you know, I'm kind of winging it here. So, you know, I don't have these references written down exactly by verse or anything like that. These are indeed parts of contained in the Bible. And they suggest that, you know, the people who are coming into and worshiping in the temple and back in the old days were indeed surreptitiously worshiping false gods and idols and such like that. So they're all kind of, these go back to the Babylonian religions also. I mean, when, you know, Moloch and Baal and all that. These are all different names and versions of the same Babylonian gods which were worshipped in Babylon, the originating center and Satan's holy or unholy city, however you want to say it, and his system originated there and is still predominating throughout the entire world via his different vehicles, be it Islam or the Jewish religion or the Roman Catholic system. So the only clean or reputable religion or religious system that one could even consider to be true to the Bible is that of the Protestants. And unfortunately, they've adopted a lot of the same pagan festivities and holidays and the Sunday worship of the Mother Whore Church, which makes them the daughters of the whore. You know, and these are mentioned also in the Bible prophecy. So, you know, frankly, I'm not going to say that they're a good religion or a group of denominations or whatever, any particular. I'm not going to support any particular one or even any of it as a whole. And as I've stated fairly plainly, I believe that religion itself is a corrupt thing, you know. Organized religion seems like it just is open to attacks and surreptitious takeover by the devil. And, you know, and if I was the devil, I'd be working on, you know, deceiving as many people as I could too, you know. So I don't know if there's anything out there that God would, you know, give us okay. Hey, you guys are all right, you know. I don't know. I just don't know what to say about that. But the thing is that there's a lot of similarities in the bases and the etiologies and the functions and the methods that each of these religions use. And the fact that their enemies are basically the same, you know. I mean, Christians and Jews. You know, historically, the Roman Catholic Church has killed, you know, millions of Christians. And same could be said for, you know, Muslim or Islamic religious practices and persecution throughout history. But there's some things to think about and maybe apply to the concept of the two legs of the beast theme or whatever. Just thought I'd get that down and see what you think. You know, again, don't take my word for it, and I'm kind of using you know, a lot of conjecture, and I'm thinking about things, and I'm seeing things in a different way, and you know, they may or may not pan out to be the whole truth, but you know, I'm just trying to go over again some of the similarities of the two. You know, still the question remains, you know, are these indeed two legs of the same beast? And I would suggest yes. And so, you know. So think about it, comment, discuss, share, add anything that you find to support or deny the theme or the thesis in the comment section below. You know, add what you can, put it together. Maybe something here that I've said will click with somebody and they'll come up with some new information that would support or deny. Either way, you know. So, I'm going to leave it there for today. And, wish you peace, love, and power. And may God bless all of you.